The boundary conditions are used to determine the refraction also. For that, we are considering this figure. Okay, so consider D1 or E1 and D2 or E2 making angles theta1 and theta2 with the normal to the interface. Okay, so using equation 8, we have E1 sin theta1 equal to E1t. From the figure, you can see E1t is equal to E1 sin theta1 and E2t is equal to E2 sin theta2. Or it can be written as E1 sin theta1 is equal to E2 sin theta2. That is your 19th equation. Using 17 or 18, we get epsilon E1 cos theta1 is equal to D1n and D2n is equal to epsilon 2 E2 cos theta2. That is also taken from the figure. You can see D2 value and D2n values. Okay, so from this, and D1n equal to D2n, that is also we have found. Therefore, we can write that epsilon 1 E1 cos theta 1 is equal to epsilon 2 E2 cos theta 2, and that is your 20th equation. Dividing both these equations, you will get tan theta 1 by epsilon 1 is equal to tan theta 2 by epsilon 2. Since epsilon 1 is equal to epsilon naught epsilon R1 and epsilon 2 is equal to epsilon naught epsilon R2, equation 20 becomes tan theta 1 by tan theta 2 is equal to epsilon R1 by epsilon R2, and this is your 21st equation. And this is the law of refraction of electric field at boundary free of charge. In general, interface between two dielectrics produces bending of flux lines as a result of unequal polarization charges that accumulate on sides of the interface. And this is all about boundary conditions.